Hi and Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nur Akila binti Azmi with matric number SIF170032 and my final year project are under supervision of Professor Dr. Ramesh T. Subramaniam and Associate Professor Dr. Ramesh Kasi. And today, I will be presenting my final year project entitled of Alterations of Metal Carbonate by Ascorbic Acid for Supercapillary Faradaic Electrode. For introduction parts, battery such as lithium-ion battery and supercapacitor are often selected as the energy storage devices in various practical applications. However, due to their low power density and low energy density, a new hybrid type called supercapacitory was invented. It is a combination of beneficial characteristics of battery and supercapacitor. Supercapacitory consists of battery type material as positive electrode and carbonaceous material as negative type electrode. Herein, in this research, cobalt carbonate hydroxide binder free electrode are fabricated via hydrothermal process by using ascorbic acid. Next, we move to the objective of the research. There are three main objectives. First, to analyze the effect of heating time and different concentrations of KOH on the formations of cobalt carbonate electrode. Second, to investigate the structural analysis and electrochemical properties of developed materials. Lastly, to determine the optimized cobalt carbonate electrode for supercapacitory applications. In order to study the effect of different concentrations of KOH and the effect of heating durations on the formations of cobalt carbonate, the experiments have been conducted. In order to differentiate all the electrodes that have been used, the electrodes were labeled as COC14, COC16, and COC18 for 14, 16, and 18 drops respectively. Therefore, for the first result that I have been achieved is XRD analysis. In XRD analysis, COC16 was chosen due to its highest specific capacity as compared to the other electrode. The electrode was heated at different hydrothermal reaction time, which is 6 and 22 hours. Apparently, most crystalline peaks were observed at the sample heated for 22 hours. All peaks displayed by COC16 heated for 22 hours can be indexed into two different phases, which is nickel carbonate hydroxide and cobalt carbonate hydroxide. It signifies that 6 hours is too short to allow the crystallizations of the sample to occur. So, next, for the CV analysis, based on the figure, show the highest specific capacity at 5 mV per second, which is 1014.60 capacitance per gram with rate capability of 67% as compared to COC14 and COC18. Even though COC14 and COC18 demonstrate lower specific capacity than COC16, the difference in the rate capability of the electrode is not significant. It reveals that the concentrations of KOH does affect the specific capacity but not the rate of capability. Next, we move to the effect of hydrothermal reaction time for COC16 electrode. Based on the result, it displays that COC16 heated for 6 hours shows the highest specific capacity and highest rate of capability at 67.2% compared to COC16 heated for 22 hours, which is 48.14% at scan rate 50 mV per second. This is due to the lower effective surface area caused by the higher agglomerations or larger particle size due to the adequate reaction for the interactions to occur. From the CD result, the figure shows the comparisons of sample for all different concentrations of KOH at 1 ampere per gram. Due to the smaller particle arrangements, closely packed with less particle aggregations, the discharge time of COC16 was longer than the other's electrode. Thus, it shows that it has the largest capacitance. The second figure illustrates that the COC16 heated for 6 hours took longer time to fully discharge, which indicates its capability to hold charge longer than its counterpart. Lastly, the EIS analysis was further performed to investigate the essential performance of the active electrode materials for energy applications. Figure A illustrates the Nyquist plot for all electrodes at frequency range of 0.01 Hz until 100 kHz. From the Nyquist plot, The RS value for COC14, COC16, and COC18 are 1.03, 1.16, and 1.37 ohm respectively. The difference between these values can be considered negligible because the conductivity of the electrode are almost similar. Next, figure B demonstrates that COC16 heated at 6 and 22 hours exhibit obvious difference in RS value, which is 1.16 ohm and 2.15 ohm respectively. This proves that the longer reaction time can decrease the conductivity of the electrode.
In conclusion, conclude that the concentrations of TOCs as a chemical reaction activating agent and heating reaction influence the structure, particle size, and the electrical chemical performance of the cobalt carbonate hydroxide. That's all from me. Thank you.